मोड इज नथिंग बट द ऑब्जर्वेशन विच रिपीट्स मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ टाइम. ओके सो व्हाट इज द मोड? द ऑब्जर्वेशन विच रिपीट्स मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ टाइम, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ मोड. द ऑब्जर्वेशन विच रिपीट्स मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ टाइम इज कॉल्ड मोड. इट मीन्स सपोज आउट ऑफ 60 स्टूडेंट्स, सो सपोज इफ 10 स्टूडेंट्स हैव गॉट ओके 15 मार्क्स आउट ऑफ 20, ओके एंड नो वन हैव गॉट actually the marks 50. Suppose if we have 60 student, so 10 student have got 15 marks, then 5 student got, suppose if we take it in ascending order, okay, suppose there are 0 students who have got, okay, so there are one student who have got 20 out of 20. Okay, there are 2 students who have got 15 marks, 3 students who have got 10 marks, 4 students who have got 12 marks, whatever that. Okay, so see how many students? 4 students got 12 marks. So 12 repeated 4 times. So therefore mode is nothing but 12. Okay, because 12 repeated maximum number of time. Suppose in any observation, suppose we have a 10 observation, 0, 3, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and 5. So what is mode here? See, check which one out of all these observations repeated maximum number of times. So 0 repeated once, 3 repeated twice, okay, 2 repeated twice, 4 repeated thrice, and 5 repeated twice. So therefore the 4 repeated maximum number of times, therefore mode is nothing but what? 5. Sorry, 4. Because 4 repeated maximum number of times, like this. Okay, so this is called as what? Mode. So the observation which repeat maximum number of time is called as what? Mode. Okay, so for discrete data, so again we have these three types of data. First is for discrete data. So first, for discrete data or ungrouped frequency distribution, ungrouped data, what is the mode? Suppose if we have this example, we have find the mode of this. Okay, so example 1, find mode of observations. We have 2, 3, 5, 2, 0, 1, 6, 2, then 3, 2, 2, 7, 7, 2, 2, 1. Okay, so these are the observation. So see what is mode here? 2 repeated how many times? See, clearly you can see 2 repeated maximum number of times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so here 2 repeated maximum number of time. Here observation 2 repeats maximum number of time. Okay, so this 2 repeat maximum number of times. So therefore what? Therefore mode is nothing but 2. This is for ungrouped data. Okay, so second example, let us see. Suppose if we have find mode of, the observations are like this, 2, 5, 8, 9 and 36. What is the mode for this? 2, 5, 8, 9, 36. Okay. So here there is no observation which repeat maximum number of times. So how can you find the mode for this data? Okay. So for this data, the no observation which repeat maximum number of time, we don't have any observation which repeat maximum number of time. Therefore, what here? No observation which repeats maximum number of time. So therefore, mode is not defined. Always remember this. So these type of examples might be there in your online examples. So you just need to check which observation is repeated. So if no one is repeated, then mode is not defined. These small examples would be there. Okay. So you could just observe that and just try to check whether which one is repeated. So maybe this is the case. Let us see. Find mode of, suppose 2, 2, 5, 8, 9, 36. So how can you define mode for this? So here 2 repeated 2 times, 9 repeated also 2 times. So which one out of these 2 is mode? Okay, so in such a cases, we just take the average of that 2 observation which repeat same number of time. Okay, so 2 and 9 repeat same number of time. 2 and 9 repeats same number of time. Okay, and so therefore what? Therefore mode is nothing but average of these 2. Means 2 plus 9 divided by 2. And what is this? 2 plus 9 is nothing but 11. 11 divided by 2. And 11 divided by 2 is nothing but what? 5.5. Like this. This is nothing but mode. Okay, so hope you got this. So this is for ungrouped data or discrete data. And what about the frequency distribution? Ungrouped frequency distribution. Okay, so next is ungrouped frequency distribution. Frequency distribution or group frequency distribution or so how we can just find out the mode for this. So let us see the example. Find mode for following data. The data is here. So x size and their frequencies are given. So xi is suppose 10, then 11, 12, 13 and 14. And what are their frequencies? This is 2, 16, 27, 19 and 5. So any cases, which one is more? This is 27. Yes, try to figure out it. So in such cases, what is mode? Mode is nothing but mode is the observation whose frequency is maximum. Okay, check which observation has maximum frequency and that will be our mode. So here if you observe, the observation 12 has maximum frequency 27. Okay, it means what? 12 repeated maximum number of time, its frequency is 27 maximum. What does it mean? It means what? 12 repeated 27 times and it is the maximum number, maximum repetition. Okay, so therefore the mode is nothing but what? 12. Okay, so here observation, the observation 12 repeats 27 times. Okay, it is actually maximum out of all. Okay, so therefore what? Therefore mode. So simply mode is denoted by Z. So as we denote arithmetic mean by X bar, so mode is denoted by Z. Z is nothing but what? 12. Okay, in such examples, so in a group, ungroup frequency distribution, so the observation which has a maximum frequency, okay, that is called as what? Mode. So what about a group frequency distribution? Okay, so the group frequency distribution is simply, we have the result for that, for group frequency distribution. Okay, so let us see for group frequency distribution how we can find out the mode. Okay, so simple result is here, we have that. So mode is nothing but mode is equal to Z is equal to L. I'll just introduce these all notations, but let first write me to just I will give you the formula and then we'll one by one see all notations what are the meanings. Okay, L plus in bracket fm minus f1 upon 2fm minus f1 minus f2 into h. This is the result to find out the mode for the group frequency distribution. So what is L here? L is nothing but lower boundary of modal class. Okay, whatever that modal class, L is nothing but lower boundary. Suppose 0, 500 to 1000, this is the modal class. This is the upper boundary and this is the lower boundary. Okay, so L is nothing but 500 in this case. This is just an example. Okay, so lower boundary of the modal class. What is the second F1? FM is nothing but what? Frequency of modal class. Frequency of modal class. Okay, so what is F1? What is F1? F1 is frequency of pre-modal class. Frequency of pre-modal. Pre-modal means what? The class which is before the modal class. Okay? Pre-modal class. We'll see this in the example. What is nothing but F2? F2 is nothing but frequency of post-modal class. The class which is after the modal class. Okay? Frequency of post-modal class. Okay? And what is H? H is nothing but width of the class. Width of modal class. And what is modal class? This is very important. So the modal class is what? Whose frequency is maximum? Because everything is depend on modal class, and that we need to figure out clearly, otherwise everything will goes wrong. Okay, so what is modal class? Whose frequency is maximum? The class having maximum frequency is called as what? Modal class. Isn't it? So now let us see the example for this and just try to understand how we can find out the mode for this class. Find the mode for following distribution. Find mode for following distribution. So what is that distribution? It is below 30 classes are given. These are not open end classes. So this is open. These are open end classes actually. So let us see. It is below 30. Then 30 to 60, 31 to 60. Then 61 to 90, then 91 to 120, 121 to 150, and 121 to 150 and above, 150 and above. Okay, and their frequencies are also given, frequencies. So 22, 198, 110, then 95, then 42 and 33. These are the frequencies. See, here we need to just change the classes. We want a continuous classes. We don't want a open end classes. So to do this, because see, open end classes, what is the meaning of open end classes? This 30 and this 30, here is 30 also, or otherwise there is a same number, 60 60, but 60 and 61 are here, they are different, so we need to just convert them into the continuous classes. And how we can continue convert them? So now the classes, class boundaries are, so here the class boundaries, because we don't have a correct boundaries here. Are the class boundaries? So it is below 30.5. Then second is what? 30.5 to 60.5. So add 0.5 in upper limit and subtract 0.5 for lower limit in this way. So this is 60.5 to 90.5, then 90.5 to 120.5. So now see, here we have the same limits. Okay, so the upper limit for a previous class is same as the lower limit for a next class, 120.5 to 150.5. We are just subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit and add 0.5 to the upper limit. This is the basic idea that we have already done. Okay. So then 150.5 and above. Okay. Now my work is over here. And just what is the modal class? Just figure out it. What is the modal class here? Check whose frequency is maximum. So this is, I think, maximum. So this is my modal class. This is my modal class. And see, whatever the frequency of modal class, this is my L. Okay, lower limit of the modal class. This is my FM, frequency of modal class. Frequency of pre-modal class, this is F1. Frequency of post-modal class, this is F2. And H is nothing but 30. That's it. Okay. So therefore what? We have all the values. And therefore mode is nothing but Z is equal to L plus in bracket FM minus F1 divided by 2FM minus F1 minus F2. Into H. Substitute all the values. So this is nothing but, what is L? L is nothing but frequency, lower limit of the modal class, it is nothing but 30.5, okay, plus what is fm, it is 198 maximum frequency, minus f1 frequency of pre modal class 22, this is 2 into 198, okay, minus f1 is 22, minus f2 is nothing but 110 into 30, okay. And if you have a right calculation of this from the Kelsey, so you will get this is 30.5 plus 20, all the calculation, and the value of this is nothing but 50.5. this is my mode for this frequency distribution, if you understand this.